it's the most bizarre thing. I just was in a boat for 5 days, and now I'm sitting here and I'm seeing a huge chunk of plastic floating around. Then I'm seeing a piece of a car floating around. Then I'm seeing a tire, and I'm seeing a buoy, and I'm seeing a fishing net. This problem needs to be solved. Yes, we're gonna clean up the Great Pacific Garbage Patch, and we will have a heck of a story behind it. My name is Dan Vanderkoy, and I work for the Ocean Cleanups, and I've been with the Ocean Cleanup for just over 5 years now.
And I'm sitting with a dude I met 5 years ago.
My name is Florent Beauvert, and I'm the head of creative and documentary productions at the Ocean Cleanup.
All right.
How do you like this shot? Look.
My role is to document the stories of the Ocean Cleanup and make sure we create powerful and engaging content for the audience.
Spare no expense.
We spared no expenses.
The reason we are here is to capture the plastic tsunami that we've been promised.
We, as an organization, are on a mission to rid the world's oceans of plastic.
The way the Ocean Cleanup tries to achieve this mission is by developing and scaling technologies to deploy in rivers and also in the open ocean.
We are about to tow Interceptor 007 from the Coast Guard base to Bayona Creek.
The Interceptor is kind of a floating garbage truck that you place at a strategic position in a river, and then it just waits there for the plastic to come to it and then extract it automatically and dumps it into dumpsters.
80% of the plastic that is on beaches comes from 1,000 rivers around the globe. So by intercepting the trash with our Interceptor 007, we will be saving a lot of plastic and waste from making its way onto these beaches.
Meanwhile, I'm gonna try to not die in potentially the most toxic river on the planet.
This is not an event. This is not something that should actually be happening.
I actually went to the Great Pacific Garbage Patch on an offshore mission in 2019, and that's the first time I actually saw the problem with my own eyes.
When you are there and you're in the middle of the ocean and you're seeing toothbrushes and fishing nets and nothing makes sense. We have done a hell of a good job causing damage to our planet. This is the only Earth that we get. If we mess this one up, there's no second chance. This entire organization started when a 16-year-old kid, our CEO and founder now, Boyan Slat, went scuba diving in Greece and saw that there was more plastic bags than fish.
And that just blows my mind. Something so clear in his mind, what he wanted to do at such an early age.
We've been developing technology to rid the world's oceans of plastic ever since Boyan had this idea.
That for me is really mind-blowing. The research and scientific team are using GoPro now. Over the years, they develop an algorithm using GoPro footage to detect plastic from the surface of the water. That informs cleanup system where to go next, where to have the best impact.
I've always been a passionate storyteller, and that goes back as far as when I was a kid, and I never really thought I would be able to do anything with it. Started thinking, you know what, there's got to be something out there that I could use my talent for and make a difference on this planet. I know that what I'm doing and what we're doing and what we are watching happen is something that a generation from now will be looked at as a moment in history. takes time, it takes commitment, it takes ongoing work to make these dreams happen.
And we have been through it all.
It is 3 p.m. in Rotterdam, 9 p.m. in Klang, Malaysia, 8 a.m. in Kingston, Jamaica, and we are live at the Long Beach Coast Guard Base in beautiful Southern California.
It has been an incredible day, really. We started around 6 o'clock this morning at Long Beach, and we towed this thing in the Pacific Ocean to Biona Creek.
Kindness is not just being kind human to human. It's kindness to this one planet that we're on. How is this not the most common sense thing for every person on this planet?
I'm a father now. I know that we must do something for our children to have the same playground and the same nature to enjoy that we've had.
I just am a firm believer in do good. That's my religion.